Hi and welcome back to my channel. Today I have a different video to share. A company called Phomemo reached out to me and asked me if I would be interested in having a look at their thermal printer. And of course I said yes, and you see me here unpackaging the little printer. It comes with an instructional sheet where everything is explained, but this little thing is so easy to use that you really don't need any instructions. I think you see me now open the printer. It's a thermal printer and you need thermal paper, which of course is also sold by the company Phomemo. You don't need any ink for this printer because it works with thermal properties of the paper. And what you need to print is the app, and you can download the app on your iPhone and also on your Android phone. And you can connect your printer with Bluetooth. That's pretty easy. And then you have different options. Here you see me opening the notes section where you can edit different kinds of notes. You can add these speech bubbles and write some text in it. See me typing in the text. Today I am borrowing the phone of my daughter to film this video because I need my phone to print. And there you can see, you can move it around, you can go to the gallery and add a photo, you can add icons and little emojis. That's a really fun thing. It's perfect for any kind of planner stuff, I think. What you always have to keep in mind is that this is a thermal paper. At first I thought about making maybe a junk journal spread, but sometimes I'm using my heat tool in the junk journal and that would make the whole paper black. What you also can do is print any image from your phone with this printer. And here I have downloaded a free word art graphic from Pinterest, and I just cut it out so that I have just the words on it, and then I can resize it with the app and print it. When you print the first time, you have to connect the printer here and then push the print button again, but that is something you only have to do once. I choose the highest thickness of the lines that works best, I figured out. And here you have the first print, and I think that's really beautiful to decorate your planner or maybe an envelope you sent to someone. Other options you have are templates. Here you have different frames and different images. Let's print out this cutie. And there you also have options about the thickness, and I always pick the highest thickness as I don't waste any ink, as there is no ink, so it's just a heat. And the prints are better when you pick the highest thickness, I believe. What you also can do is make some lists. Here are some to-do lists as well. And you can click the list and then you can edit it. And you can just type in all the works you have to do and then adhere this to your planner. I'm just typing in an empty space because I want to have empty lines so I can fill in this sticker later when it's in my planner. What's perfect with this paper is you can color on it with normal pencils or felt pens, and that works super great. Here I didn't pick the thickest lines and I think it was a bit too light, so I just print another one with the thicker lines and this looks much better. The printer has a chargeable battery, which you just have to load with a USB connection, and the cable comes also with the printer. Here I print another decoration piece for my bullet journal spread I will do at the end of the video. And I picked a Christmassy image, and as I said, you can print any image from your phone. That's really fun, I think. What you also can do with every frame they have, you can type in the words directly on your phone. And I just tried that out. I decided I want to try the word wishlist, and then I can add this to my planner and add my Christmas wishes to it. Isn't that cute? I really love to play with this. I think this would be a perfect idea on your Christmas list, maybe, if you are a planner girl. You also have a schedule plan for school, so you have the weekdays and the hours, and you can print this for your school planner. Then you have different graphics. They have a bunch of Halloween graphics in here, and I hope very much that they will update their app and you will get Christmas images. That would be really nice. There is a comic section with comic clip arts, and now I'm having a problem with loading my page. I don't know what the problem is. Maybe it was the internet connection. But there are more different graphics where you can play with. And here I'm trying the banner function from the toolbox. There is only a function to print a ruler. Maybe you don't do this because now my printer prints a really big banner with the word December on it, and it's so big. To be true, I have no idea what to do with it, and it wastes a lot of paper. Maybe this would be something for a packaging where you write on "Don't bend it" or something like that. Or maybe you like to label boxes in your cupboard, for example, so that you find your stuff easily. Then you maybe need these big words. Now I'm printing the weekdays with the right date on it that I've created in Canva. And I just adjust it to the biggest size so that my words are big enough, and then I go to print. And these are the days I will cut into strips and use them in my bullet journal. Here I am printing a free printable of a December at a glance. Another interesting function is the scanning function, and I just doodled a Christmas tree. I made it with thick outlines because this scanning software doesn't take just a photo of it. It creates the outlines of your image. After it is scanned, you can adjust the brightness, for example. When you're happy with it, you can print it and color it in with felt pens or any kind of markers. To print a little bit more decoration for the bullet journal, I go to the photos back again, and I'm picking a flower painting I've made a while ago, and I will print this out. And as this is only monochromatic, you get a really interesting look. Of course, you can print any photo. You can print family photos, you can print free printables, vintage images. These all will look very interesting. You have also the option to adjust the brightness and the saturation. This app has so many options and things to play around with, and you can download it and even use it without the printer just to try it out and to have a look what you can do with it before you maybe get yourself a printer. And when you look in the description box, I have a 10% coupon code for you from Phomemo, so you can save a little money. The printer does not only come in the steel color, they have a pink one, a white, a black one, and one with a piano graphic on top. I think now it's time to work on the bullet journal layout. Yes, I'm a bullet journal addict. I never share any layouts because most of the time they are not very very pretty, and I also don't do many artsy things in them. I just prefer using stickers, and sometimes I do a little bit of lettering, but I'm not good at lettering. So it's just for my planning and for my work, and that I keep everything together. I also don't have a bullet journal notebook. What I am using is a big traveler's journal. I have made this on my own from SnapPap, and I have different things inside, and these dotted signs are from a German company called Herlitz, and they are not very big. I get in 2 to 3 months, but I don't mind that because I don't want to have a very thick planner. I have something where I record my orders in, and I have a sketchbook in here when I have ideas to write them down. I also want to add in the tree, and I will color it in with my aqua markers. These are the very cheap ones from an action store, and I really love those markers for bullet journaling because they never bleed through the pages. The Phomemo printer is available at the Phomemo website, and I will link to it in the description box. And you will also find it on Amazon. I have this little printer in my Amazon storefront, so you will also find the link to this in my description box. And here is the finished bullet journal layout. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope you see us next time for another art journaling video. Bye!